if you're just joining us, a very warm welcome. Let's go to Western Uganda, where efforts to save River Ruwizi from depletion may not be worthwhile should the concerned authorities continue to play games. According to Mbarara City and Lake Mburo National Park authorities, massive awareness campaigns have been conducted and the mantle has now been put to the National Environment Management Authority, NEMA. But as you will see in the following report, NEMA authorities say the two entities are the biggest beneficiaries from the river and should be able to settle efforts that are driven towards the conservation of that particular water body. Let's take a look. The drive to conserve River Ruwizi, which originates from hilly areas of Buhejo, can be described as a mere ceremonial cover-up.
We are so much concerned with this river because it's the only drainage we have in here. So what we've seen, bottles, silting taking place in our river.
Shifting blames to whoever is in charge of managing the river, that is why we constituted the Ruwizi Catchment Management Committee. And moreover, the Lake Mburo National Park management is the stake in that committee. So it is better we combine efforts, maybe in concept writing or mobilizing financial resources, and we address the problem of catchment management.
It's estimated that over 40% of wetland that act as the water catchment areas for River Ruwizi have been degraded.
Drainage with shallow lakes, when the siltation is not properly handled, we can lose the lake. A case in point is Lake Wamara. It shrinked a big percentage of acreage due to siltation. So if we don't also take care of the siltation that is eroding the Lake Mburo and other satellite lakes in the park and outside the park, we are likely to lose the physical future of Lake Mburo.
Surprisingly, city authorities have since distanced from the fight to conserve the diminishing river, as they blame NEMA for not doing much.
This river, as you see, it is not majorly for Mbarara City. It just passes through Mbarara City and goes to Lake Victoria. It comes from the hills of Weju and some hills of Wambara. So it passes through. And Uganda National Water and Environment should be in charge of this river because it gets money from the people. They supply water.
The city authority is still availing us the list of those who are involved in beverages, the list of those who are involved in waste handling, and also the health facilities. Once we finish the list, we shall communicate to the stakeholders and we engage them further so that they know that they have an obligation of taking care of what they generate and get it out of the environment.
Mbarara Regional Referral Hospital has also come on the spotlight for polluting the river with medical wastes.
There is a lot of siltation, there is a lot of effluent materials coming from various businesses and factories. We have dumping, we have littering, and all those are hitting our river. But we are not doing nothing. That is why we want proper physical planning. Physical planning means aesthetics and order in building and construction.
Over 200 people had acquired over 500 hectares of land in the buffer zones of the river as tycoons continue to scramble to turn its water catchment areas into farmlands in the eyes of concerned agencies. The 8,200-kilometer river discharges its waters into Lake Victoria through Sango Bay Wetland Forest, which means that if it's not preserved, the pitch of its destruction will be a national disaster. Story by Halson Kagure for the news in Mbarara City.